Well, staying with news from India, in the wake of the blast at a convention centre in Kochi in Kerala, the state's chief minister, Pinari Vijayan, has addressed an all-party meeting in the state capital. The meeting comes after multiple explosions rocked the state of Kerala. The bombings had targeted a prayer meeting of the Jehovah's Witness sect at the Kalamsari region in Kerala on Sunday. The incident took place at the Zamra International Convention and Exhibition Centre, where around 2,500 people from across the state had gathered for a prayer session. Three people were killed and 51 others injured in the explosion at the prayer meet.
We have 17 persons in different hospitals. 12 of them are in ICU and 4 are critically ill. 3 of them are ventilated, so we are giving every possible support that is to be provided to them. We are giving that all the support.
Visuals of the incident showed fire, rescue and police personnel in large numbers evacuating people from the site, which has been cordoned off. Kerala's police chief said an improvised explosive device caused the blast at the convention centre. Moreover, hours after the blast, a 48-year-old man claimed responsibility and has surrendered, but the police are yet to fully verify his claim.
One person has surrendered in Kodagara police station in Thrissur rural in the morning, claiming that he has done it. His name is Dominic Martin, and he claims that he belongs to the same group of Sabha. We are verifying it.
Meanwhile, the National Investigation Agency has taken over the case as directed by the Home Minister Amit Shah. It will be probing the terror angle, including national and global links. Our senior correspondent Siddhan MP has more.
Three people have been killed and more than 50 people are injured in what is an improvised explosive device blast in Kerala's Ernakulam district. This is a blast that took place on Sunday morning around 9:30 a.m. India time. This was a blast that took place during a religious congregation of the Jehovah's Witnesses community. According to the community, more than 2,200 of their people were present there inside a hall when these series of explosions, at least three of them, went off and causing severe burn injuries to the people that were present there. So at least 50 people are undergoing treatment in various hospitals, and we're given to understand that at least few of them have suffered severe burn injuries and their critical condition is being monitored at this point in time. As far as the Kerala police goes, they have clearly stated that this is an IED blast, which is a crude bomb blast made using simple materials and simply available electronics and fuels. So what we have to understand right now is that in this case, on Sunday itself, there was a breakthrough. The police said that there was this person, Martin Dominic, who claims to be a former member of the same community, Jehovah's Witnesses, and he surrendered and assumed total responsibility for this attack. Investigation is underway. At this point in time, we're given to understand there are at least three agencies investigating this case. One is the special team formed by the Kerala police itself. In addition to that, there is the National Security Guard, which is the counter-terrorism operations agency. Then in addition to that, there is the National Investigation Agency, which is also the premier agency to probe terrorism-related cases. So all three of them are investigating this case and also interrogating Martin Dominic, who, according to the police, had surrendered after, you know, just few hours after this attack had taken place. Let's also remember that there was an all-party meeting earlier this morning in Kerala. All parties resolved that they must work towards restoring and, you know, ensuring the continuation of communal harmony and social harmony in Kerala, given the fact that this was an attack on a religious event that took place yesterday.